Today I'm going to show you how to approach history taking. Want to learn the art of history taking and improve your consultation skills? You have clicked on the right video. If you're new to this channel, hi, my name is Dr. Erwin Kwun. My mission is to help doctors lead a happy and fulfilling life. I publish new video every Thursday on the subject of happiness and success. If you've not already subscribed to this channel, don't forget to subscribe and ring the bell so you're notified first each time I release a new video. Imagine yourself taking a history and the conversation flows smoothly between the patient and you. Effective communication is key in clinical practice. Your approach to consultation is vital in eliciting a history. How do you take a history? Traditional medical history model consists of presenting complaint, history of presenting complaint, past medical history, family history, social history, drug analogy history, and system review. All this medical information is relevant and could be collected by a computer. Do you agree? A robot could complete this task more effectively than a doctor by getting patients to fill a questionnaire. However, robots cannot provide the human-to-human interaction doctors offer. The expression of genuine empathy and sensitivity is what differentiates a doctor from a robot. Doctor-patient relationship is at the heart of medicine. As a doctor, you're privileged to get a glimpse in the private life of your patient. It is important to give your undivided attention and listen to your patient, acknowledge what the patient has to say, and show understanding. The reason I'm covering this is to stress the importance of the process that occurs during history taking. When you consult, you communicate with the patient to help them. The doctor needs to involve the patient and develop a rapport. The conversation needs to flow naturally between you and the patient. Some doctors have not developed the consultation skills. They elicit a history like a robot. History taking is an art you can master. Remember, you are a person interacting with another person. Don't let yourself act like a robot. Doctors have developed a variety of consultation models, including Burns Transactional Analysis, Calgary Cambridge, Neighbor, and Pendleton. While there is no ideal model, Calgary Cambridge is a very practical framework that promotes patient-centered approach during a consultation. It incorporates the physical, psychological, and social aspects of the consultation. Calgary Cambridge is a 5-stage model. Can you see the two threads that run throughout the consultation? These are building the relationship and providing structure. Let's start with building the relationship. There are various ways you can build a relationship during the consultation. Firstly, you can use appropriate nonverbal behavior. Show appropriate nonverbal behavior by maintaining eye contact with your patient, facial expression, adopting an open posture. Make sure that your position and movement is also friendly. Being aware of vocal cues such as rate, volume, and tone. If a patient speaks to you with a low tone, it could be that the patient is low in mood. If you find yourself reading or writing notes or use a computer, you need to be aware that this can break the rapport. So make sure that you do this in a manner that does not interfere with the dialogue or rapport building. You can show confidence by smiling and greeting your patient when they first come in. How can you develop rapport with your patient? You need to put your patient at ease. You need to make the patient feel comfortable. This is done by accepting legitimacy of patient's views and feeling, by being non-judgmental, communicating empathy and showing understanding and appreciation of the patient's feeling or predicament is important in building rapport. Make sure that you acknowledge the patient's view and feeling openly. Provide support to the patient. Express your concern, understanding, your willingness to help, and acknowledge the coping efforts and appropriate self-care. It needs to be a partnership between you and the patient. It's important you deal sensitively with embarrassing and disturbing topics, and you need to be making sure that you make the patient feel comfortable. And even when you're examining a patient, make sure that you're not causing any harm to the patient, and you need to be showing that you're sensitive in your approach. How do you involve the patient in the consultation? It's important that you share your thoughts with patient to encourage patient's involvement. So you can tell the patient, what I'm thinking now is XYZ. It's helpful when the doctor explains rationale for questions or parts of physical examination that could appear strange to the patient. For example, if a patient is coming with back pain and you're asking a question about bowel control or bladder control, or you want to do a rectal examination, it's important that you explain what's the reason. Before you proceed with physical examination, explain the process, ask for permission, and offer a chaperone if needed. The second thread in Calgary Cambridge model is providing structure. There are two ways you provide structure. It's important that you make organization overt. Summarize at the end of a specific line of inquiry to confirm understanding before you move on to the next section. You need to progress from one section to another using signposting. Use transitional statements. Include rationale for next section. For example, after gathering information from the patient, you might want to summarize before you proceed to examination. You might say to the patient, "Before I examine you, is it okay if I make sure that we're on the same page?" And then you summarize what you understand from the patient and check understanding before you proceed to examine the patient. The flow of a consultation is very important. As a doctor, you will know the difference between a consultation that flows smoothly and a consultation where it's very rough. So attending to the flow is important. You need to make sure that you structure your interview into logical sequence. You need to make sure that you attend to timing and keep the interview on task. The first stage of Calgary-Cambridge model is initiating the session. It consists of establishing rapport with the patient and identifying why the patient has attended. First impression counts. It is your chance to set yourself up for success. Greet the patient and smile. It shows confidence and helps develop a relationship with the patient. At this stage, you need to generate an agenda that incorporates the patient and your needs. You need to be curious about your patient and engage in the consultation with an open mind. In the second stage, this is where you're gathering information. Most doctors have heard this aphorism. Listen to your patient, they are telling you the diagnosis. Listening is at the heart of effective communication. Let your patient tell their story freely, without interruption. Be present and listen to your patient. As a doctor, you need to explore the problem using open and closed questions. Start with open questions to encourage the narrative the patient has stored for you. Listen actively before trying to interrupt with questions. Use all your senses to listen. Listen to what the patient is saying, listen to the tone of voice, to the pace, look at their facial expressions, look at their gestures. You will pick up on cues that usually reveal more information. A crucial part of stage 2 is establishing the patient's ideas, concerns, and expectations, and developing the structure of the consultation. Attention to structure is a thread that runs throughout the consultation. It ensures that you're conscious of the flow of the consultation. Avoid jumping from one section to a completely different section if you don't want a dysfunctional consultation. When a history is disjointed, you could miss something important from the patient. It's vital to be organized in gathering information. You need to communicate clearly to your patient and ensure the consultation flows. The third stage consists of the physical examination. It is important to gain informed consent and offer a chaperone if needed. The fourth stage is explanation and planning. It is important to provide information in chunks rather than in great detail at the end of the consultation. Make sure you check the patient's understanding throughout so that both parties are on the same page. Where appropriate, you can use written or diagrammatic information to help clarify explanations with your patients. Remember not to use jargons when you're explaining to patients. Make sure that you're using simple lay terms everyone can understand. In explanation, it's important to check and chunk. When you've actually explained to a patient 3 bits of information, make sure that you check with them before you go forward. Usually, you can provide 3 to 5 bits of information and then you check with them before you go forward. What you don't want to do is overload the patient with a whole lecture on something and then you've lost the patient. Finally, you need to conclude the consultation. Close the session by summarizing and ensuring that the agreed plan is clear to you and the patient. I have created a PDF copy summarizing the concepts of history taking you can download. Link in the description below. In real life, Doctors often confuse the Calgary Cambridge guides and the traditional medical history framework as alternatives. Most learners use the traditional medical history as a guide for history taking and disregard the communication skills learning. It is worth pointing out there is a difference between the content and the process of a medical interview. Using the traditional medical history, a list of content as a process of a medical interview often leads to a rigid consultation, focus on close questioning and exploring primarily biomedical information. The content and the process of history taking are equally essential for effective communication to occur. The best clinicians are aware of both the content and the communication process of the consultation. They integrate both concepts in practice. If we look at gathering information as an example, we need to understand and apply the process skills to explore the content to be discovered. The process skills for exploration of a patient's problems include to be able to encourage the patient's narrative, balancing the use of open and closed questions, attentive listening, facilitative response, picking up cues, clarification, time framing, internal summary, appropriate use of language, additional skills for understanding the patient's perspective. By applying these process skills, you'll make sure that your consultation flows. Now let's take a look at the content to be discovered. This can be divided into three different groups. The first one is biomedical perspective. This is the disease, sequence of events, symptoms analysis, and relevant systems reviews. The second category is a patient's perspective, also known as illness. This consists of exploring the patient's health belief system. In this section, you explore the patient's ideas and beliefs, concerns, expectations, effects on life, and feelings. The third category is background information. This gives you context of the patient. It consists of past medical history, drug and allergy history, family history, personal and social history, and review of systems. To enhance the Calgary Cambridge guides, Kurtz and colleagues recommended the need to marry the content and the process elements of medical interview. They propose a revised content guide to the medical interview. You can see the revised content guide is more comprehensive. It incorporates both biomedical and patient perspective and includes a physical examination within a single unified model. If you want a PDF copy summarizing the concepts we have discussed today, click the link in the description below. If you want a video on the other consultation models, please let me know in the comment section. If there's enough interest, I will make a video in the future. If you like this video, subscribe to my channel where I'm sharing more great video every week. Thanks so much for watching. Take care, everybody. See you in the next video.